والذين لا يدعون مع الله إلهًا آخر ولا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق.
The authentic narration that is on the authority of Abi Umama radiyallahu an Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إن الصاحب الشمال ليرفع القلم ست ساعات عن العبد المسلم المخطي أو المسيء فإن ندم واستغفر الله منها ألقاها وإلا كتبت واحدة. وحسن هذا الحديث الشيخ الألباني رحمه الله تعالى. Abu Umama, he mentioned that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the angel that is on the left, he raises up the pen for 6 hours from the Muslim servant who has done something wrong. If he has regret and he seeks the forgiveness of Allah from the sin, then the angel will throw it away. But if he does not repent, then it is written as one sin. So from the narration, we understand that the angel who writes down your bad deeds, when you commit the sin, he doesn't write it down for 6 hours. That does not mean that you are not to repent immediately. Rather, that's a fadl min Allah alayk. That's a virtue from Allah upon you or upon us, that the angel does not write down the sin for 6 hours. That's Allah's mercy. But that doesn't mean now you're supposed to procrastinate making tawbah, or you commit a sin at 5 o'clock and then you're going to count the time, right? And say, well, I have until 11 before the angel writes it down. So you're going to keep enjoying this. Hold up, 11, daddy. Be careful. Don't play around with the deen like that. Shaitan is wicked. He'll use the hadith. Say, well, the angel don't write it for 6 hours. You good, you know? You're all right. Take your time. Who's to say you won't pass away before that 6 hour period? Death comes all of a sudden. And now you want to say, Tubtul an. No. No tawbah at that time. So the hadith itself is just mentioning that this is a virtue from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the angel does not write down the deed for 6 hours. So if you repent before that, it's never written in your book. But if you don't repent before the 6 hour period, it's written down. But still, if you make tawbah correctly, Allah will forgive you. But the only thing, that deed is still written in your book, even though Allah has forgiven you, it's still there. That's the difference. That's the difference. So it's better to repent and not have the deed written in your book than procrastinating the tawbah, and then it's written, then you repent later and you're forgiven, but the deed is still written there. We don't want the deeds written in our book. If an individual, he commits a crime and the judge tells him, we will erase this from your record, but you have to do these things. You have to do such and such hour of community service. But if you don't do the community service, we're going to write the crime against you. It's going to be on your record, but it won't affect you because you did do some jail time. Which one you going to prefer? The act is not on your record at all. That it doesn't show at all on your record. Nobody wants evil written on their record. This is in the dunya. We don't want to go for a job interview and then when they do a background check, this felony, this misdemeanor, this. Nobody wants that. So how much more so on the day of judgment when you're standing in front of the Lord of the worlds and your records are being produced? What do you want to be on there? We have to have concern for these affairs.